So here is our dashboard. So you can see here, we have several steps to complete this milestone. So it says schedule a call with a peer partner. Guys, the easiest way to get a partner is to go to your squad, go to your community. Just type, please, if you are in need of a peer partner, chat me on this line. Drop your WhatsApp number. And trust me, lots of persons will reach out to you. That's the easiest way to do that. You don't need to beg people. Just drop your WhatsApp number and you are good to go. So the second one, it says complete your skills tracker. So click on this link to download it. But this is how it looks like. So what they're expecting you to do is to rate yourself. So you can see here the instruction says enter 5 if you're already exceptional in the area. So in growth mindset, if you're already exceptional in that area, rate yourself a 5. If you're not, rate yourself 3 or 2. 3 is okay if you know some stuff about it. If 4, it is if you possess good or solid skills. 1 is if you're minimal, if you have a minimal or no skills in that area. And then 2, if you have little experience. So just rate yourself. How do you do that? Click on any of them. Type the number you want to type. So I'm going to type 3. Click on enter. You can see. So 3 is, you can see here, 3 is yellow. 4 is light green. And 5 is dark green. So that is how you rate yourself. So I'm going to go back. So the third one says the core. So this is the most important part of these steps. So it says the core, and the good thing is that they gave us a script. So just download the script, or you just jot these questions down into your booklet. Just drop it down. While you're dropping them, while you're writing them, write the answers as well. It is not a bad thing if you're reading your book and you're answering your partner. It is not. Write those questions down and write the answers as well. So the third step is fourth step the reflection. So these are the questions that you need to answer. So after you've done the pair coaching session with your partner, this is the one that you need to submit, not this. And they said copy and paste questions A to H in a new Google Doc. So these questions, you copy them and you paste them. So let me show you how, because some persons reached out to me and be like, okay, sorry, please, I don't understand how to go about this peer coaching. I'm kind of scared. You don't have to be scared. I know it's the first time. I was also scared as well. But then I did it. And I did it with not just one person. It's lots of people. Or persons. Okay, so research and booking, project management, taking meeting minutes, transcribing, and then electron record management. So you're probably wondering, okay, how do I even know these skills that I'm having difficulties with? That is where your skills tracker comes in. So these are the skills. You can see these are mentioned are part of this thing. So look at them. The ones that you rated 2 means those are the skills that you need to improve on. The ones that you rated 5 are your strongest skills. So those are answers to the question. You can see, Abby. Okay, so you go back. So the third one, it says, which do you personally find the most challenging? Is it the soft skills, technical skills, or the tools? And why is that? So for me, the the one that I find the most challenging are the tools. So because we have several tools, so for example, we have Google Workspace and we have Microsoft Suite. These tools, they kind of do the same thing, but as a VA, you sort of have to have like a knowledge of those tools, even if you might not eventually use them. So, but you have to have a knowledge of them. So we have several tools. So knowing that there are several tools that does the same thing, but you just have to have basic knowledge of them, it is quite challenging for me. I don't know about you. So that's the answer to my fourth question. So for the fifth one, it says, share one thing that you enjoyed the most about the course so far. Okay, so for me, one thing that I enjoyed the most is the fact that the course is beginner friendly. You guys, you don't need to reach out to somebody and say, please explain this, please explain that. Everything, as you're watching the video, you're understanding, you're understanding the concept. There are resources that will back you up. So I love that. And this is not part of it because it's just one thing. The fact that there's a community. Do you get? There's a community where you can just go and drop your thoughts. And somebody's also thinking your thoughts. I love that. So that is that about part A. So for the part B, it says you decide who will be the coachee and the coach first. So like I said, I'm both the coach and the coachee. So we're going to be using the goal model. So as a coach, tell me about a goal that you have either for this class or for your career in the next year or so. And is the goal SMART? Okay, so as the coachee, I'm going to respond. Okay, so my goal is to become a certified virtual assistant at the end of this 8 weeks program. You can see, don't go and give yourself one long goal that you cannot even... So is the goal SMART? Yes, it is. How is it? How is it a SMART goal? So for the S, specific, remember I said it's to become an ALX certified virtual assistant. So you can see, simple. Is it measurable? Yes, it is measurable. You know that it is measurable when I have achieved my certificate from ALX. Is it achievable? Yes, it is achievable. If I stay committed, if I attend all the sessions, if I complete my tasks, if I submit my assignment, and then I'll be able to meet ALS certification requirements. Quite easy, right? And then is it relevant? Yes, it aligns with my career goal of becoming a professional virtual assistant. And then lastly, time bound. Yes, the goal has a clear deadline. You can see within 8 weeks. So by the end of the program, I should get my certificate. So quite easy, right? Yes. Okay, so for the second one, so we've been able to answer the G part. So the O, it says, okay, so don't forget this. It says coach summarizes what he or she heard. So, okay, so as the coach, okay, so if I'm to get you correctly, you said your goal is to become a certified virtual assistant, right? Yes. So that's it. You have summarized it. So the next one, it says the R, that's reality. So what is your current reality? Is there a barrier that might block you from achieving this goal? Okay, so as the coachee, I'm responding. Yes. So the barrier would be knowing how to manage my time because I have other things that I'm doing. So the barrier is knowing how to manage my time. So as a coach, you will now summarize it. Okay, so you have. So you're trying to say that the barrier here is time management, right? Yes. So the O, what are some options that you have to minimize or eliminate that barrier? You can list 3 options or 4. So as the coachee, I'm going to be responding. Okay, so the options that I have put in place would be to set reminders to keep me accountable for each classes. The second would be to prioritize with top 3 methods. So I will ensure that the top 3 tasks that I'm going to be doing that day, ALX, completing my ALX course for that week, is in those 3 tasks. And then the third is to set boundaries and say no to non-urgent distractions. So I'll communicate with my family, let them know that, okay, so at a certain time of the day, I'm going to be busy, so they don't distract me. And then lastly, I'm going to badge similar tasks. So tasks are similar, I'll do them at once and not postpone. So you can see, I've been able to answer that. I gave you 4 options. So as a coach, you summarize what your coachee has said. And then lastly, the W, what is the way forward? What is your commitment? What will you do? Okay, so my way forward will be to, I will ensure that I complete all my weekly tasks before deadline. And then commit 2 to 3 hours daily for learning. And I'll also remind myself why this certificate is important to me. Because, you know, this certificate, being a virtual assistant, is going to offer you flexibility. Remote work, you're working from your home, anywhere, you're working from there. Good money, good income, and then growth. That's my way forward. That's my commitment. So the last one last thing is, they said, do you have any requests for me? How might I help you meet your commitment? So to answer that, okay, most persons, they were like, okay, I want you to be my accountability partner. Because if I don't have somebody that I'm accountable to, I will just keep postponing my weekly tasks, and I'm not able to meet. So that is it, guys. It is easy. It is easy. So what you need to now do is come here, copy all this, go to your Google Doc, copy and paste. Once you've copied, let's do that. So you can see. Okay, I'm going to go to my Google Docs. So I'm going to my Google Workspace. So just come here, blank. So I'm not going to be answering this question. You're going to have to do that yourself. Control V, and this is it. So you have pasted it, give it a title, reflection, whatever. So let's assume these are the questions and these are the answers. So what they need you to do is to copy the link. So the share, you can see share here. Click on it. Okay, so once you've clicked on it, ensure that you give access to this, because if you leave it unrestricted, it is only you that can open it and no other person. So ensure it is on anyone with the link. So once you've done that, copy the link. It is a link that they need. Copy it. Then you go back to your dashboard. So remember, we've done the first one. So we've answered the questions. The submit, you can see here, it says just follow. Trust me, once you read the instructions, you are good to go. Some persons are not even patient enough to read the instructions, so read it. So once you've copied the link, come down here. It says submit your skills tracker tax. So that link, so this is for the skills tracker. So how do you get the link of your skills tracker? So just come to it, this. You see there's also a part that says share. So click on it. You've done that, you need the link, so you can see it is already on any one of the links. So copy the link, come to your dashboard and paste it. So once you paste, come to this dashboard, Control V, see my link here. So click on save. Once you've done that, to ensure that it has saved, even though you are seeing red, you might be seeing red away and you are scared that, oh, is it error? It is not error, it has saved already. Just to, for confirmation, click on check submission. Once you see congratulations, all text passed, you are good to go. You have done that. The same thing with your Google Docs. Come in, paste the link, click on save, and yes, that's simple. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with your friends. Yes, don't forget, your friends that are also on this, your ALX journey. Share it with them. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comment section, and I'll be happy to help. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.